A very warm welcome to everyone to this fourth video related to Google Classroom. In the previous videos, we talked about how the notifications would appear under your stream tab. So whatever you are adding, it will come in the stream tab. You can see the material, the different topics and the assignments in the classwork tab. Then in the people, we can see who all are the students or the teachers who have been invited to the classroom. Now our last tab is left, which is the marks tab. So let us see how to assess the students for their test, for their assignments or for any of their quizzes. So for that, we just go to any particular assignment. Let us click on classwork. And as you remember, yesterday I gave a quiz. Okay, so in this quiz, I can see that out of 42 now, 3 have submitted the quiz. So it is coming here as 300 and 39 are still assigned because they haven't yet submitted the quiz. Let us go to one of the assignments that I previously gave to the students, and you can simply click on any of the assignments. And you can see that it is 12 have submitted, 28 have to still submitted and 2 have been marked. So if you want to see any particular assignment, you can just click on that and you can see its details. So let us view the assignment. From this view assignment, now you can open any of the assignment and you can fill in their scores by checking it. Or you can also change this option. Just go to this arrow in front of all, click this, and you can change your options. You only want to see who have been handed in. So these are the students who have submitted their assignments. Now I can give them the marks. There are two options of giving in the marks. The first is I can simply click here. Okay, so I can click for Aru that it is 90 marks. I will click on these three dots and I will click on return. I again click on return. So make sure that you have to press this return button twice. If you don't do that, then we will see what will happen. So you can see here that Aru's name is now coming under the marked and she would be informed via the stream or her email ID. Now let us see for Channi, if I press 90 and if I press return just once, then what will happen? And if I cancel this, see, it is coming in the draft. It means that the number hasn't been saved and the number hasn't been informed to Channi. The marks would return to Channi only when I again click on this three dot, I click on return. And in this box also, I click on return. And if I want to send any comment privately to Channi, so I can write, better luck next time. Okay, so I can also send a comment. Just return. And now you can see that it is no more in the draft because it has come under the marked student's name. So this is the one way of how we can assign our students, how we can assess our students. The other way is you can just view the assignment. You can open up any of the assignments. Okay. And when you open up the assignment, along with the assignment, here is the assignment. So you can check it. And here is the marking section. So you can give the student marks from here. You can also add a private comment, good work, and you can go to return, then again on return. Okay, so these are the two ways. Now if I go back to my work, let me close this assignment tab. Okay, now if I go back to my assignments, I'll see that Mani has been marked here. Okay, so these are the two ways of assessing the student. Now how to see the marks of all the students? For that, go to marks Okay, when I go to marks now, it will give me the detail of all the students and it will give me a detail of all the assignments that I have given. And these are coming out as blank because the students have not yet submitted it. You remember that these are the four assignments that I gave to the students in my last video. So they haven't yet done it and they will do it as and when it is required. You can also see the due date which is coming on the top. That for the quiz it is 11th June. For the regional rural banks there is no due date. Similarly for the question that we asked, when was NSE established? And for the scam of Ketan Parekh, the last date is 11th June. Okay, these are the assignments that I have checked earlier. In the first row, you are getting the average, the class average of all the students. Now, suppose I want to edit these marks. This is for Aditya, I gave 80 on 80. So you can go here, you can view the submission again. And the students who have submitted late, below their name, you can see this option, done late. So you can decide to whom you want to give full marks because the students submitted the assignment well in time. And when you can identify the students who have submitted their assignments late. So this is how the assessment would be stored in your drive and you can access the assessment anytime when you want. So this is a record of all your assessments. Right, so in the stream tab, these two things are still coming because they are still due. So this is how you can make a flipped classroom where you can not only share material with your students, but you can also make a streamlined assessment for the students where they will know if any new notification has come up here because an email would be sent to them. And whenever I check any assignment, their marks too would be known to the students. I hope you liked this video. You can try various options in this Google Classroom. There are various things that are still left. You can also upload your photo here. So try different things and learn different things and be in continuous interaction with the students in this tough time. Thank you so much.